Hello, Silvana. Good evening.
Good evening, teacher.
Okay, how are you doing?
Excellent.
Excellent. Okay, and your baby?
She's sleep.
She's sleeping. Okay.
Sí, she's sleeping.
And what time does she go to bed? ¿A qué hora se va a la cama ahí? At night, ya en la noche. La noche.
It's the pen. Sometimes 8, 9, and sometimes 11, 9, and sometimes 10, 9.
Oh yeah, you don't have a specific time.
No.
Well, I know it is like very difficult. Okay, but she's healthy. Está sanita.
Sí.
No se enferma. Okay, good. That's good. I think that. That is very nice. She looks like you. Se parece a ti.
Así dicen todos.
Sí, like the face. Yes. Okay. Well, that's good. Yeah, because the father and the mother, they are always trying. It's like a small fight, una pequeña pelea. Whatever que se parece. Yeah, and it is good. It is a good satisfaction. Right? Okay, that's nice. I like that. Okay, good, Silvana. Let's see. Roxana, hello. Good evening, Roxy.
Good evening, teacher.
How are you doing?
I'm okay. How about you?
Well, I'm very good, but it is like getting hot. Se siente caliente. Yeah.
Do you have a ventilador?
A fan. Yes, I have a fan. Can you see that this moves the air?
Okay.
Yeah. Sometimes it is good to take a shower when we come from work. Cuando venimos de trabajo, es bueno una ducha rápida, like very fast.
Yes. For the coronavirus.
Yes, of course. Especially if you have a contact with people.
Yes.
Maybe
especially
it can be in the office or if you attend customers. Si se atiende a clientes. Yes.
Yes.
And there are some people that they are careless. Son descuidados.
Careless. Ah, yes.
I have seen that. Sometimes when I go to a bank or a supermarket, and sometimes, well, there is a person in the door, and that person is asking for the mask and for the temperature. Entonces esa persona pide, bueno, pide la temperatura, ve lo de las mascarillas. But if there weren't that person, si no hubiera esa persona, people don't care. La gente le vale.
Yes.
Yes, that happens.
I work at the bank.
Oh, you work at the bank, really? Are you a cashier? Yes. Are you an assistant, a secretary, or a executive?
Como
you work with
executive.
Really? Nice.
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, so you see a lot of people during the day.
Yes.
Yes.
All day.
Yeah, and it's tiring working with people. With customers, clientes.
It's difficult. Yes.
Very difficult customer. They are demanding. Son como bien demandantes, bien exigentes. Some.
Right. Yes, teacher.
Okay, good.
Okay.
It is good to hear that. Okay, Jenny. Hello, Jenny. You are so concentrated. Está muy concentrada, mujer. I think we can hear you. Creo que no te podemos escuchar.
Good evening, teacher.
Good evening.
How are you?
Well, I'm very good. I took a shower, me bañé. I think you took a shower too, right?
Me too.
It is good. Yeah, it is getting hot. Se siente caliente, desesperante.
Yeah.
Okay, so that's it. Jenny, what time do you usually arrive home? ¿A qué hora llegas a casa?
Depend. Usually at
2
p.m.
Okay, good. And do you have lunch at home or outside?
Yeah.
Adentro, ¿en tu casa o afuera? Outside.
The job. Me quedo como a 5 minutos.
Ya. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Entonces, vengo a almorzar aquí.
Okay. Yes, yeah, it is better. Ah, sí, but your work is close. It's near your house, right?
Yeah, sí.
That's why, yes. Yeah. Take advantage. Aprovecha.
Yeah.
Nice. Yeah. Yes, you have to take advantage. Yeah, that happens. Okay, so let's see, Roxana. What time do you arrive at home? ¿A qué hora llegas a casa?
Usually I arrive my home at 5 p.m.
At 5 p.m., okay.
Yes.
Are you studying or just working?
I'm just studying. Working and studying, yes.
Okay, what do you study?
Licenciatura en Mercadeo.
Major, okay. Marketing. Okay.
Yes.
Sounds very interesting.
Oh, yes.
I like marketing. And when I began to study at university, I wanted to study marketing. But that major, that career was not in the university. In the University of El Salvador. Cuando yo entré, no estaba esa carrera. And the next year, the university, yeah, had that career. Y después del siguiente año ya tuvo esa carrera.
How do you study? Okay, estudiaste, what?
¿Con qué? ¿Con quién? ¿O where?
No, ¿qué? O sea, licenciatura en
inglés. Yes, major in English. Mm-hmm. English, licenciatura en inglés, opción enseñanza.
Mm-hmm. Yes, my sister study esa licenciatura.
Really?
And
she graduated from the university or she's studying?
Solo en la universidad.
¿Se graduó? ¿Se graduó or no. She's studying? Estudiando.
Está estudiando.
Okay, yes. Okay, good for her. Okay, so you can practice English.
Yes.
Okay, that's good. Yeah.
She helped me with the homework. Okay,
yes, of course. You can ask for help. Puedes pedir ayuda. I graduated in 2012. En 2012 me gradué. Yeah, a long time ago. Like yes. 9 years. Okay, so yeah.
Yeah. 9 years.
9 years, yes.
9 years ago.
Can you see my gray hair? ¿Puedes ver mi cabello gris? Yes, I have Canada.
Okay. No.
Yeah, it's part of the wisdom, part de la sabiduría. Okay.
Yes.
Let's listen to Elenita que se me está escondiendo en José. Hello. I think they are preparing their opinions. Creo que están preparando sus opiniones.
Teacher.
Hello, Jose. How are you doing, my friend?
Hello, teacher.
Hello.
I'm good. And you, teacher?
Okay, I'm very good. We were talking about taking a shower when we come from our work. Because sometimes we have contact with customers or with a lot of people. Okay. In your case, Jose, do you work in an office or do you have contact with customers, con clientes? You have contact or not?
I work in a office.
Aha, you work in an office.
I'm in contact with a sellers.
Okay, yes.
Yeah. The sellers is the contact with the customers. Okay. I am the person. Who do you say? Nexo?
Yeah. Yes. You're like the link. Tú eres el vínculo.
Oh, okay, yeah, I am the lead
between customer and sellers. Okay.
Yeah,
you work with the administrative area, right?
Yeah, I am administrative area.
Yes,
but it's so so big because I contact with logistic, mm-hmm. I contact with commercial area, with accountant department, with compras?
Yeah, purchasing.
Purchasing, yeah. Yes. I forgot.
So everything has to be working.
Yeah.
Todo debe estar trabajando.
Yeah.
Fine, detailed. Yes, okay.
Yeah.
Don't you feel like a pressure, like a lot of things to do? Or
yeah.
Job custom?
Yeah, every day.
Yes.
No, yes. I love my job.
Okay.
Really, I
that's the most important thing. If you love your job, you are okay.
You can it's so difficult, but I can do all the things that require for the work.
Okay, and you learn more in your area,
yeah.
Right? Okay, good for you. Thank you for your opinion, Silvana. And do you have contact with a lot of people, or do you work in an office, or do you work in a team? Trabaja en un equipo. Mm-hmm.
No, teacher, I received the call. The,
yeah.
I don't.
You receive all the calls, mails, right?
Mm-hmm. No, I don't have visit the client.
Okay, cool. Well, that's nice. But sometimes we have difficulties at work. We have difficulties when there are a lot of people that they don't understand. Hay mucha gente que no entiende, right? They don't understand the things that you are saying by phone, or they are complaining, o se están quejando, okay? So, ya que pues estamos hablando aquí con Silvana, se me ocurrieron un par de palabras. Okay, so, let's see. Remember, customer, cliente, complain, quejas. This is very important. Complain es quejarse. And complaints, or complaining are quejas. Okay. Sometimes we receive complaints because the customers are very difficult. People, they are very demanding. Son bien exigentes, son bien demandantes. Sometimes our bosses, nuestros jefes son demandantes. Right now, sometimes we have like bosses.
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Hello. We're talking about jobs. Hello. Estamos hablando acerca del trabajo, okay? So,
okay. I'm late, but.
A big catharsis, and we're talking about a lot of things, okay?
No, but Jose, don't share with you that the our bus is so far, and we only have communication by cell phone.
Wow, that's good.
And,
you don't feel the honest, pressure.
No, and be honest, the last time that I saw my boss was in February in the last year.
Really? Suena
yes.
Como relación a distancia. Come on.
Yes,
yeah.
Teacher.
But you work well, pero trabajan bien. You work well.
Yes.
Right?
Yes. We think. And she called us like twice a month only.
Okay. Well, it's because they have confidence.
Uh-huh.
Yes.
Confidence.
Okay. Nice. Uh-huh. Well, nice. So here we have, perfect. We have customer Hugo, my friend. Hello.
Hi, teacher.
Yes, yeah. The audio is okay. El audio está bien. Todo bien.
I am working now.
You are working. Okay, my friend. Ooh. What time do you finish your work? ¿A qué hora terminas? Or all night long, toda la noche?
11
at 11. Okay, 11. Okay, nice. Well, so we finished the class in one more hour, and you
one more hour.
Okay, let's do it. Okay, we're going to talk about time. vamos a hablar acerca del tiempo, but referente al reloj, no el tiempo, como que si fuera algo espacial, viaje en el tiempo, no. Me gustaría, but not. Okay, so to have like a review, customer, cliente, demanding, Elenita, do you remember what is it, demanding in Spanish?
I don't remember, teacher.
Complain?
Queja?
Yes. Ajá.
Yo, tengo una consulta. ¿Esas quejas son referentes nada más al empleo? ¿O se dice siempre?
No, you can say the complaints or you can complain. Puedes decir las quejas o puedes quejarte, ¿verdad? Complain es el verbo y complaints or complaining es el sustantivo. Quejarse, quejas. But you can say, for example, you talk with your mother-in-law. Hablas con tu suegra. And you can complain about your boyfriend. You can say, your son is not responsible. Your son is not romantic. And you can say a lot of things, but you are complaining.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Okay. Thank you.
You're welcome. No se quejen de mí, oigan. Okay. Boss, jefe, okay. And Jenny me va a decir que es demanding because she's so smart and she has a very good memory like an elephant. She has good memory like Elena, like Savannah. They have very good memory.
Sorry, I don't remember.
I don't remember, okay. But Silvana does, okay? Silvana remembers. Mm-hmm. Silvana, demanding. La carita de Silvana.
Es like intensos, no. Es como
intenso suena como un ex. No, demanding is exigente. Okay.
Eso, exigente, o sea, tóxico.
Intenso, no. Well, okay, después hablamos, Silvita quiere hablar de otra cosa. Okay. So demanding can be a customer can be demanding, a boss can be demanding, okay? Or even you can be demanding, okay? So here we have. Well, to start, Jesse, hello, good evening. Carlos.
Good evening, teacher.
Carlos, the gamer and the musician.
Okay. Yeah.
Hello. Jesse, the innocent woman, la mujer inocente.
Good evening, teacher.
Oh, okay, good. Mira, están llamando. Okay, so we're going to start first. What is one thing many people don't know about you? Que hay algo, debe haber algo que la gente no sabe de ti. You can be very mysterious, or sometimes we don't share our feelings or our ideas in front of the old people, mainly at work. Because with our friends, we can talk, we can share a lot of things, we can talk about our opinions, our feelings, but sometimes, even with our family, we don't talk about all the topics. No hablamos sobre todos los temas with the family. Or especially with our colleagues in our job, we don't talk about our feelings, right? Or our ideas. No hablamos de idea, nuestros sentimientos, okay? So, let's listen to Carlos, okay, my friend? Do you have one thing or two things that many people don't know about you?
Puede ser más de una.
Yes, of course, you can say 100 if you want.
Y puede ser cualquier cosa.
Yes, whatever. Whatever. Okay. Mm-hmm.
One thing many people...
Spider-Man decirlo, okay.
Ahorita, casi viene siendo así.
Okay.
One thing many people don't know about me is I fear tarantulas.
Okay, yes. And spiders, you don't like it.
Other thing? No, don't like it.
Or tarantulas. Tarantulas is the name because tarantulas are bigger than spiders. Son más grandes, right?
Correcto.
Okay, and they have hair, hasta pelos tienen in the legs. Okay, you hate those insects. Okay.
The diet I follow to lose weight.
I'm sorry. The diet, la dieta.
Diet I follow to lose weight.
Okay. Oh, okay. Weight. Yes. You have diet. Tiene dieta.
Sí.
You're going to share with me, or okay? I need to have a diet. Aquí bien chulo, ¿por qué no me ven ahí la panza, boss? Believe me.
Sí, en el trabajo.
I look like a bus driver. Parezco ahí con... Okay. So, sí. Okay. No tarantulas, you have a like strict diet. Tienes una dieta estricta. Do you have another thing?
Only that.
Only that. Okay, thank you. Well, very interesting facts. Son como... Jenny, ¿cómo se dice? How do you pronounce this word? No, no te voy a preguntar the meaning. I'm not going to ask about the meaning, but the pronunciation. Interesting.
Interesting.
Mm-hmm. Carlos? No. Elena?
Is interesting.
Yeah, interesting. Remember, interesting. Acuérdense, como que si fuera maestro de sinfónica. Interesting. Okay? Remember, that is one of the most difficult words in the basic level. Okay, thank you, Carlos. What about Jesse? Are you ready with your answer? ¿Estás lista con tu respuesta, Jesse? We want to know.
No, chair.
Okay, okay. But Elena is ready. I know that this girl is more than ready. Está más que lista. Parece scout, okay?
As a child, I would have wanted to be a Hollywood actress.
Okay, as a child.
As a child.
Okay, you wanted to be a Hollywood actress.
Yes.
Wow, but you want, maybe you can be an actress. Like, you can appear in La Rosa de Guadalupe or something like
no,
that.
No, no sé cómo decir. Right. Son actrices que a la vez
like musicals.
Yes.
And there are some yeah.
It's fantastic.
There are some plays, así se le llaman las plays que son como obras y todo eso. And they appear in theaters, aparecen en teatros, or they have some, they are, can appear in movies. Okay. Wow. So you like musicals?
Yes.
Because you can combine singing, dancing, and like acting, okay, physical acting, okay, it is a very complete like area, un área bien completa, okay, good. Only one thing, right? Yes. Okay. Very interesting, Elena. Okay. Siempre quería ser famosa. Okay, good. Let's listen to Jose, my friend. Are you ready with? I know that you are Peter Parker. I know that you are a superhero, but besides that, aparte de eso.
Yeah, apart of all of this, one of the things that people don't know about me, if in a previous job, I was the youngest supervisor ever. Mm-hmm. And the two thing is, I am a little jealous.
You're a little jealous? Yeah. In your job or with your
no
girlfriend?
No
in general,
yeah, in general, yeah,
okay,
yeah.
Okay,
yeah.
When you are the youngest, cuando eres el más joven, it is good, but you have difficulties because of colleagues, por los colegas, right? Yes, right,
yeah. Mm-hmm. All my colleagues are in the age of 30.
Yeah.
No. Yeah. And I am in this time, my age
was
21 years.
Yes, you were a kid and a supervisor.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can imagine. I have had the same experience. I was 21 years old, and the rest of the teachers were like 40, 45. Casi que eran como mis papás, unos de 50, yes. And I was the youngest, el más joven. Okay, that happens. Okay, and the second one, you are jealous. Eres celoso.
Yeah. Yeah.
Con razón alguien in estaba general, hablando. Yeah. Alguien está hablando. ¿Quién estaba hablando de intensos? Ok, good. You are jealous. Un poquito celosos. No, un poquito. Ok. Cuando queremos decir además de, we can say besides o besides that. Mm-hmm. Besides that. Mm-hmm. You can write this, pueden escribir eso. Esto sirve bastante cuando queremos agregar más información. Thank you, José. Do you have another fact or the two facts? Los dos hechos.
Only two facts, yeah.
Okay. Facts significan hechos, ¿verdad? También pueden decir esto. Facts significa hechos y ustedes pueden decir esto. In fact, de hecho. In fact significa de hecho. Okay. What about Hugo, my friend? Are you ready with one thing that many people don't know about you?
For me, my expression, my expression is angry.
You look angry.
Angry, yes. Mm-hmm. But I can become friendly. Other person. I have a question. You're happy? Yes, I'm happy. My face angry.
Your face is different than your personality, right?
Yes, yes. Uh-huh, okay.
Okay. So the first impression, la primera impresión, is that you are a serious person.
Yes. Uh-huh, yes.
But you are very relajo, right? You're like Joe, te gusta la broma, and you're very friendly. Eres amistoso, ¿verdad?
Yes. Okay. Sí, cierto modo, correcto.
Uh-huh. Yeah. A veces. Okay. Well, that's good to know. And sometimes people judge. La gente juzga. Judge because of the impression, because of the appearance. Yeah, that happens. Okay. But we can see that you're very friendly. You're very relaxed. Okay, nice. Okay, do you have another or only one? It's okay.
Other detail. For me, it's interesting. Of a scorpion, a snake, a spider.
You don't like it.
I like it.
Okay, you are afraid of. Okay, I'm going to write this.
It's interesting.
Okay, let's see. There are some phobias. Algunas fobias. Mm-hmm. So you are afraid. You can say, I'm afraid of. Le tengo miedo. I'm afraid of. Mm-hmm. Of spiders or some insects. Especially women don't like, I'm not saying that all women, no. Because of my cousins, my aunts.
My wife is scared.
Scared, yes. Yeah. They get scared. They don't like insects. When there is a mouse, they call me to kill it. Me llaman para matarlo al pobre. Yeah, because they are afraid. Tienen miedo. Okay. Okay, nice, Hugo. Thank you for sharing your fears and your opinion. Let's listen to Silvana. Okay, Silvana, do you have yours?
Yes, teacher. Many people don't know about me. No sé si se dice así, pero I had a mole of gray on the right side of my head.
You have I'm sorry, I didn't get.
Yo lo encontré así, ¿verdad? Es un lunar de canas.
Ah, really? It is big, es grande, es small?
It's small.
Small, but you paint, you color your hair. Como toda diva, ¿verdad? La mujer ese
tiempo. No, es como con dos dedos de ancho.
Incho. Ajá, huevo, de pulgada, ajá. Uh-huh. Oh, wow, really. Well,
yes.
That's nice. That's like a special characteristic in you. Good.
Yes.
Very good. Thank you. Okay, nice. Do you have one more or we are okay?
I need that.
Okay, thank you. Nice. And let's listen to Roxanne. Are you ready? Roxy. There. Okay, I think she's
done. No, sorry, teacher. I'm here.
Okay, te perdono. Okay, tell me.
Okay. What is one thing many people don't know about me? Okay. Diría many people don't know that I like to play the piano.
Nice to play the piano.
Yes. In the past, I want to be a doctor.
Wants to be a doctor in the past. Okay. A pianist doctor. Wow. Wow. How
yes. Interesting.
Okay. Nice.
Doctor pianista.
Yes. Where did you learn piano? ¿Dónde aprendiste? By your own, por tu cuenta, or with a teacher?
By my own. Actually, I'm learning now.
Okay, nice. I can see that there are a lot of musicians here. By my own, o podemos decir, by myself, como una canción de Celine Dion, que me gusta también. By myself. ¿Quién diría que me gustaría hacer el idioma? Antes no me gustaba. Ok. By my own, por mi propia cuenta, o by myself, por mí mismo, por mí misma. Ok.
By my own.
Ajá, by my own. Ok, good. That's nice.
Yes, teacher.
Now that you can see a lot of tutorials on YouTube, you can learn whatever you want. Pueden aprender todo lo que quieran. Yeah, that's it. Okay, we're going to continue in a moment with these opinions. I think that this is a very interesting question. Creo que es una pregunta bien interesante. And we are knowing much more about us. Okay, so let's see. Here we have ways to say yo también, formas de decir yo también. For example, we can say me too, or you can say so am I o so do I. Y esto lo vamos a practicar ahorita. Esta es la vieja confiable. Me too. Esa es la vieja confiable para decir yo también. Ok. Pero lo podemos decir de diferentes maneras. As I have told you, if you say the things in different forms or in different ways, it means that you know a lot of English. ¿Verdad? Si dicen las cosas de manera diferente, quiere decir que saben, pues, tienen un amplio vocabulario. Dicen, I am happy. Me too. I am happy too. Ok. Hay dos maneras para decirlo, ¿verdad? Utilizando el too. Pueden decir me too or I am happy too. O sea, fácil. Or you can say I love you. Pueden decir, vaya, si les dicen te amo, y si ustedes aman a esa persona, eso es importante. Si no, no lo digan. Me too, ¿verdad? Lo dicen yo también. O pueden decir I love you too. Ok. There are two forms to say it. Hay dos maneras de decirlo. Cuando decimos me too, o solo le agregamos tú a la misma oración que dijeron, that was said previously, que dijeron anteriormente. ¿Ok? Eso es bien fácil. And here we have the other, que esta es más, si dicen esta forma, es porque su inglés ya va avanzando un poquito más. Obviamente, obviously, you can say me too. There's no problem. But if you say this form, the person who is listening your pronunciation is going to think that you know more about vocabulary. So, I am happy, y se dice, so am I. So am I, se utiliza el so, y si es el verb be, se utiliza am y I. Ahora, si le dicen I love you, salgan corriendo. No, si le dicen I love you, y están utilizando cualquier verbo, cualquier verbo, que no sea verb be, o sea, I love you, I hate you. Bueno, así dicen I love you, después dicen I hate you. I listen to you. Sí, o cualquier cosa. Por ejemplo, I like vegetables. Me gustan los vegetales, las verduras. Entonces ustedes pueden decir, so do I. El do es importante porque es el auxiliar para cualquier verbo en presente. ¿Ok?
Teacher. Y en el caso cuando dice aquel cantante, I want to be free.
Oh, well, You're wrong, my friend. Yeah, the great Freddie Mercury. You stay in silence, my friend. Stay in silence. Quédate en silencio. Okay, good.
Chair.
Yes, hello.
Sorry, ¿puedo ausentarme durante 15 minutos y regresar?
Okay, lo ideal sería que no lo hicieras, pero si urge, okay.
Okay, we're going to es que care. Tengo que enviar una tarea, y no.
Okay, aquí vamos a estar.
Okay, gracias.
You're welcome. Okay, entonces le puedo decir un par de oraciones en este momento, ya sea utilizando el verb be, cualquiera es I'm happy, ¿verdad? Por ejemplo, or I am. Cualquier cosa, I am happy, I am sad, I am student, okay, I am hungry, y ustedes me pueden contestar, so am I, me pueden contestar me too, o si les digo I am sad, pueden decir I am sad too, okay, pero si utilizo un verbo, por ejemplo, I like horror movies, ustedes me pueden decir I like horror movies too, o me pueden decir me too, o me pueden decir so do I, okay. So this is the point. We start with Jennifer. Hey, Jennifer. I am single.
So am I.
So am I. Okay. Aunque esto sea falso, ¿verdad? Ustedes siempre tienen que decir yo también. Ese es el objetivo, que ustedes digan yo también. No te preocupes, Carlos, que no voy a utilizar la frase de Freddie Mercury. Pero voy a decir cualquier oración, ¿verdad? Ustedes solo tienen que decir yo también. Yo creo que mañana vamos a ver el yo tampoco, ¿verdad? Porque si vamos a decir yo no, por ejemplo, si le dicen, si Freddie Mercury regresa de la muerte y se le aparece a Carlos y le dice, I want to break free, él le dice, not me. Sorry, not me. Yo no, eso. Ok. Pero esto ya es diferente. Ok. We go with José. Let's see. I like romantic movies.
So do I.
Perfect. Ok. Elena, I like dancing.
Me too.
Good. Silvana, I have a baby. I have a baby. I'm sorry, we can hear you.
Me too.
Okay, good. Let's go with Naum. I cook delicious.
So do I.
So do I. Okay, good. Carlos, I play the guitar.
Me too.
Nice. Hugo. I have a pet.
So do I.
Perfect. Jesse. Hello, Jesse.
Hello, teacher.
I am married. I am married.
I not me?
No, en este caso solo quiero que me digan positivo. Este era un ejemplo nada más.
Ah, yeah. Me too.
Me too. Okay. Flor, hello, Flor. Can you hear me? ¿Puedes escucharme? Okay. No por el momento. Okay, we go with Linda. Hello, Linda. I am a student. ¿Cómo responderías a eso? Para decir yo también, Linda. I am a student. Okay. Creo que después van a comentar ellos. Sam va manejando, me había comentado, así que después le pregunto. Okay. Continue. Information questions, how, what, when, why, who, where. Jennifer, what is why in Spanish? What does it mean why?
¿Por qué?
¿Por qué? Thank you. Carlos, what does it mean who?
¿Quién?
Perfect. Jesse, what does it mean where?
¿Qué?
Where. What is where in Spanish? No.
Where is que es donde?
Donde. No. Okay. Good. Thank you. Okay. Remember we studied this. Eso es súper fácil, ¿verdad? Eso solo pertenece a un pequeño recordatorio. Los verbos, ¿verdad? Acá sería play, like, brush. Brush es cepillarse. Okay. work on trabajar, take, tomar, ¿verdad? And we don't have problems with this, no tenemos problemas con eso. Y vamos con lo siguiente, que es pues esto mismo. Mientras, I'm going to check the attendance list. Voy a revisar la lista de asistencia. Mientras los demás ya me van a comentar sus, ¿cómo se llama? Sus opiniones acerca de esto, ¿ok? Alejandra, not here. Carlos, hello.
I am here.
Thank you. Elena.
Hi.
Hi. Ernesto, no. Ever, no. Flor, yes, Flor. You are there. Ahí estás, ¿verdad, Flor? No, ok. Again, we tenemos problemas otra vez. Hugo, hello.
Present.
Thank you. Jairo, not Jairo. Jenny.
Hi.
Hi. Jesse.
Hello.
Hello, José.
Here.
Thank you. Linda.
Present.
Good. Mabel, no. Mauricio, no. Naum.
Present, teacher.
Thank you. Reina, not Reina. Roxana, hello, Roxana. Okay, not. Bueno, ya no está Roxana. Creo que tienes problemas de conexión. Ah, no. Sí, es que por lo de la tarea que dijo. Vane, no. Sam is driving. Someone está manejando. And Silvana, right, Silvana? Okay, thank you. Okay, we go now with Naum. Okay, my friend, tell me, what is one thing many people don't know about you?
Okay, teacher. And the thing is that I was 5 years. My father left me alone, you know.
Okay.
And that's it was very difficult because you know that in that moment you need someone to help you to live, I guess.
Yes.
And in like 10 years ago, I saw him in Metro Centro, and I tried to speak with him, and but he told me that he don't know who I am. And I feel very sad that that's the page of my life that I was difficult. But nowadays I have a stepfather and I love him.
Okay, wow. I think that is very personal. Thank you for sharing your anecdote. And that is a chapter, es un capítulo. That's a very hard chapter in your life. And that's the life about. There are a lot of difficult situations, and we have to overcome. Tenemos que superar eso. We have to overcome.
That's okay.
So, but now you are okay.
Yes, I have. You know that I have a stepfather, and he support me. He understand that when I want to know something, but I feel good.
Believe me, there are some stepfathers that are, but
better
than biological father. Because in my case,
yes,
that happened to me. I have a stepfather, and he's a really nice person. I really admire him. And the advice, ¿verdad? Los consejos, the advice are really good. So,
sí. Okay, teacher.
Nice. Okay, thank you. Thank you for sharing. Advice significa consejo o consejos, ¿verdad? Así es, simplemente, ¿verdad? Advice. Okay, let's listen now to Jenny. Are you ready, Jenny?
Okay, good evening. I'm not sure, but I don't know. Fit people know that I work at as a dental assistant.
Dental assistant.
Yeah.
Good. And did you like it?
Yeah.
And you learned different things. Aprendiste cosas diferentes. Okay, now. So if we have problem with our teeth, we're going to call you, okay?
Yeah. okay.
Thank you. Thank you for sharing your experience. And what about Linda? What is one thing many people don't know about you?
I love football. I love watch partidos.
Soccer matches.
Soccer matches. And it's weird, es algo raro quizás que a alguna chica le gusta, pero a mí me gusta mucho.
Oh, that's nice. So you can watch soccer matches with your boyfriend and you can have fun, pueden divertirse. That's good. You can go to the stadium. That's good for you. Okay, perfect, Linda. Thank you. And now, Flor. Hello, Flor. Do we have problems with the internet? Okay, I think we do. Okay, thank you for telling. And the last person. Jesse. Jesse.
Hi.
Hello. No me ha dicho qué es lo que no sabe todavía.
Many people, no. Sí, vea. Many people don't know about me is I study technical in engineering industrial.
And that's very interesting, but you don't work in that area, right? No trabajas en esa área.
What? ¿Cómo?
Si trabajas en esa área, do you work in that area?
Yes.
Oh, wow. Well, that's good. I didn't know that you studied that. Well, interesting facts. Just muy interesante. Okay, thank you, Jesse. Later we're going to have a speaking activity. Okay, here we have information questions. Please help me reading. Elena, 1 and 2, please. Read it.
Where do you have lunch on weekend?
Perfect.
Weekdays.
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry. Where do you live?
Live.
I live.
ese verbo es bien confuso. Huh? Live. Where do you live? Thank you. Okay, we'll go with Jose, then Jennifer. This one and two.
How do you get to your job?
Mm-hmm.
When is your birthday?
Yeah, when is your birthday? Yes, birthday. Jenny, they know.
What day is today?
Mm-hmm.
What do you want to eat?
Thank you. Naum?
How often do you go to the beach?
Yeah.
How often do you do exercise?
Excellent. Okay, Silvana, 1 and 2. And then we have who?
How often do you exercise? And what's your phone number?
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Hugo?
What's your wife, husband name?
Mm-hmm.
What's your pet's name?
Perfect. And why do you study English? Okay. And here we have movies and descriptions. Solo que vamos a ver antes de las movies and descriptions. I need to clarify that you don't have problems with numbers. Here we have 0. Okay, remember that you have 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. Y aquí tenemos 20 or 20, 30 or 30. Aquí decimos 13 y aquí 30. Es más relajado. 14, 40, 15, 50. Okay, 16, 60, 17, 70. Okay, pero vamos a trabajar del 0 al 60. Okay, so I'm going to ask some numbers for you, and you tell me, okay? Se lo voy a decir en pares, okay? Jenny, we start. 14, 40. En pares, se lo voy a estar diciendo a todos, okay? So we can have like a better idea about numbers, okay?
14:40.
Nice. Silvana, 15:55.
15:55.
Okay, good. 50. Okay. Let's see, José. 16:59.
16:59.
Perfect. Okay, Carlos. Let me see. 19:90.
19:90.
Perfect. Jesse. 29:99.
29:99.
Perfect. Okay. Hugo, we go. 17:77. Perfect. Nice. Linda, sería 18:81.
18:81.
Good. Naum, no te he preguntado, ¿verdad, Naum?
Yes, you did.
Yeah, I did. I'm sorry.
No, teacher, I'm kidding.
Hey, vaya, ¿ves? Porque por eso no nos creen las mujeres, Naum. Okay.
He's a liar.
Yeah, I can see.
No. He's
a liar. Okay. 13:33.
13:33.
33. Good. Excellent. Okay, we're talking about numbers. Mabel. Hello, Mabel. Good evening. Can you tell me?
Good evening.
Hello. Can you tell me 17:67?
67.
Thank you. Hello, Alejandra. Are you busy? ¿Estás ocupada, Alejandra? Hello. I think she's a little bit busy. Bien, creo que sí está un poquito ocupada. Ok. Doubts. ¿Hay dudas con respecto a los números? No, right. Easy cheesy. No tenemos dudas. No doubts. No dudas con respecto a eso. Son bien fáciles. Ok. So we're going to... We're going to go with time, okay? We can say that there are different forms to ask the time. Podemos preguntar la hora de diferentes formas. What time is it? What time does the meeting start? What time do you arrive at work? What time do employees leave? ¿Verdad? Leave, este es como vivir, ¿verdad? En el caso de Elenita, mira, lo mismo, como decir vivir, okay? Leave, es lo mismo. Okay, so what time is it? Quiero ver si aquí tengo las otras formas. Yes, yes, después vamos con las otras formas. Okay, so what time is it? ¿Verdad? It's, ahorita en este momento solo vamos a ver la forma más básica para decir la hora. Ya vamos con la otra forma. Yo sé que ustedes como son, you're very intelligent, you're going to learn the different forms to say the time. Aquí fácil. It's 1:08. Es importante pronunciar 8. El final de la letra, 5 con B, 5, ¿verdad? 9, ¿verdad? So, what time is it? It's 1:08. 1:08 por el momento, ¿ok? So, let's listen to Jesse. What time, please?
What time does the meeting
start?
Start.
Vamos, Jessie.
Start.
Sin la E al inicio. Start.
Start.
Yeah, start. Sin ni la S.
No.
Okay. Ah, te comiste la S. Ok. And what about the answer?
It starts at 11 o'clock.
It starts at 11 o'clock. Mira, la S es tu verdugo, ya te vi. Ok. Ok. Acuérdense, siempre, spider. Stark, Tony Stark, ¿verdad? No Tony Stark, no, Tony Stark. Ok, Jenny, please, number 3, what time?
What time do you arrive at work?
Mm-hmm.
about 6:48 a.m.
Perfect pronunciation, 8. Okay, let's listen to Mabel, please. What time?
What time do employees leave? Mm-hmm. Usually around 7 o'clock, mm-hmm, or 7:30.
Very good. Usually around 7 or 7:30.
Around.
Yeah, we don't have problems with this. This is a very easy topic. So complete the questions using what time and do or does. O sea, le vamos a agregar what time y también le vamos a agregar do or does. Okay, so here we have, there is a recruitment. Okay, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. And Hugo is going to help me. And Silvana is going to help me. And who else? And Linda to start. Okay, Hugo, Silvana, and Linda. Okay, Hugo, you start or ladies first? Mm-hmm, depends. Okay.
No, number two.
Okay, number two. Go ahead.
Number two. Let's meet for the meeting on
Wednesday.
On Wednesday. Great. Do you arrive? Mm-hmm. I arrive at...
Hugo, vamos a agregarle what time or what time does. Okay.
What time? Okay, great. What time do you arrive? I arrive at 8:15 a.m.
Good. A.M. A.M. Mm-hmm. Y ese verbo es arrive. Arrive. Okay.
Arrive.
Así como yo les he preguntado a ustedes, what time do you arrive home? ¿A qué hora llegan a la casa? Y usted, right, teacher, no me pregunte eso. Okay. So, what time do you arrive home? Thank you. Right. Excellent. Okay. Silvana. 1, 3, 4, or 5. Después Jessie, ya vi que Jessie quiere.
Number one. There is a
recruitment.
Recruitment of new employee on Tuesday. Really, what time does it start? Mm-hmm. It starts at the 9 a.m.
It starts.
Start.
Ya como le dije a Jessy, ya se pusieron ahí nerviosas. Start. Ve, ya me está agregando la... No, start.
Start.
Le voy a hacer una evaluación solo con esas. Ay, a la Jessy la primera, ok. So, recruit, acuérdense que... Bien. Linda,
What is recruit?
Ok. Linda, do you remember qué es recruit?
No, teacher.
Okay, Mabel, what is recruit sin el ment? So the recruit. Do you remember?
Perdón, teacher.
Esta, recruit. Ya voy aquí con mi lapicito. Recruit.
Recruits.
Mm-hmm. No, okay. Linda, ¿qué me dijiste? Sorry, I didn't hear you.
I searched the worry and...
Come on. Tricky, tramposa. Okay. What is recruit?
Reclutar.
Yes. Recruit es reclutar y lo vimos ayer y lo vimos antier esa palabra. Recruit. ¿Qué, verdad? Eso lo hace human resources. Recuerden que lo hace recursos humanos. Ahora, recruit es reclutar, pero recruitment es el reclutamiento. O sea, la selección... pero no de fútbol playa, sino que la selección de empleados, ¿ok? So, recruit, reclutar, ¿verdad? O contratar, ¿verdad? Y recruitment, ya es el reclutamiento o contratación. Estos son verbos, son bien importantes. Please try to keep in mind. ¿Ok? So, number one and two are taken. Linda, you go, and then Jessie. And finally, Carlos. So, Linda.
Okay, number three. Mm-hmm. Tomorrow I have to go to the photocopy center. Me too. What time do the photocopy center open? It opened at 6:50 a.m.
Muy bien. Cuando, como estamos hablando del photocopy center, estamos hablando de una cosa. Entonces, ¿qué, cuál vamos a utilizar?
Dos.
Das.
Das.
Das. Ajá, sería me too. Cosa que también acabamos de ver, ¿verdad? Me too, ajá. ¿Cómo sería la pregunta entonces?
What time does the photocopy center open?
Thank you. Thank you. Very good. Okay, Jessica. Mm-hmm. Four or five?
Five.
Five.
Mm-hmm. Amanda has to take some
reports
to many departments on Monday.
Mm-hmm.
What time do they open? They open around 7:30 or 8:05.
Excelente, ya ves que es bonito pronunciar five. Ok. reports and departments. Ok, reports and departments. Thank you, Jesse. Ok, number four, my friend Carlos, the guitar man.
Ok. Wendy, do you want to have dinner with me after the workshop?
Mm.
Yes. But what time does restaurant close here? Oh, around 7:25 p.m.
Uh-huh. Mira, vea, Wendy ya me la están invitando a salir. Bien, en este caso vamos a tomar en cuenta el plural. Restaurants. Como es plural, no sería what time does, sería
do.
Uh-huh.
Okay.
What time?
What time do restaurant close here?
Sí, entonces, si solo dijera restaurant, sí, sería does. Entonces, si se dan cuenta, aquí te dan la pista, ¿ve? Aquí se utiliza it, aquí se utiliza it, aquí se utiliza I, ¿verdad? Perdón, aquí, you. Uh-huh. Entonces, igual acá. Y como dice, yep, the restaurant. Uh-huh. Ok, excellent. Excellent, my friends. Ok, let's continue. Vamos con el siguiente, the next exercise. What time is it? Tenemos diferentes formas para decir what time is it y le voy a preguntar one by one. Okay, what time is it? What is the time? Do you have the time? Excuse me, do you know what time is it? Could you tell me the time, please? Okay, what time is it? What is the time? Do you have the time? Excuse me, do you know what time is it? Could you tell me the time, please? So, let's listen first, Silvana, then Mabel. Okay, pronounce only one. Pick one.
No me dejó repasar.
En tu mente repasaste. Mm-hmm.
Do you have time? Do you have the time?
Thank you, Mabel. Naum.
What time is it?
Mm-hmm. Naum, José.
Excuse me. Do you know what is the... I'm sorry. Mm-hmm. Excuse me. Do you know what the time it is?
Mm-hmm. Excuse me.
Excuse me.
Yeah, thank you. José and Jenny. Okay.
Could you tell me the time, please?
Mm-hmm. Jenny, Carlos.
Excuse me. Do you know what time is it?
Mm-hmm. Jenny con los ojitos como el gato de Shrek. Así. Mm-hmm. Carlos, de nuevo.
Do you have the time?
Yeah, Hugo, Jesse.
Excuse me, do you know what time is it?
Mm-hmm. Jesse, Linda.
What is the time?
Yeah, Linda, Elena. Okay, Elena, Roxana.
Excuse me, do you know what time is it?
Thank you. Roxana, hello there. Okay, Flor. Okay.
Could you tell me the time, please?
The time, yeah. Could you tell me the time, please? Thank you. Okay. Flor, hello, Flor. Can you hear me? I think that the signal is, it is not so good, right, Flor? Creo que la señal no está como que muy bien. Okay. Yes?
What time is
it? Okay, what time is it? Thank you. Alejandra, are you there?
Hi. What time is it?
What time is it? Thank you. Perfect. Bien, así que ya tenemos, we have like another idea how to express time. Tenemos como una idea como que más completa, cómo expresar el tiempo, express the time. I'm sorry, I'm going to have some changes. To advance, para avanzar un poquito, we're going to, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. Le di a otra cosa acá. Okay. Movies or books, descriptions, okay? Do we have a volunteers? Tiene que ser breve, no tiene que ser mucho, ¿verdad? Y sí, tiene que mencionar el nombre. You have to mention the name of the movie or the book, okay?
Okay, teacher, I'm going to start.
Please, my friend, go ahead.
Okay, I hope don't offend nobody.
I hope not.
Okay, I'm going to describe the Bible. Mm-hmm. It is a collection of religious books based on different kind of situation. Mm-hmm. The Bible was written by different people, and nowadays it's very difficult to talk about this topic because they may different ideas, and the religion in the old world is different. That's only that I'm going to share.
Well, I think it is a good point of view, and the Bible is the book number one in the worldwide.
In the world.
Yeah. I mean, uh-huh. Because it is the most famous. Es el libro más famoso mundialmente. Yeah.
Uh-huh. And the Bible has like 66
books.
Mm-hmm. or texts, I don't know.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Okay. Uh-huh. So
it and books- they and mm-hmm. And then describe different situation in the past and the future. You believe in that?
Yes. Okay. I think it is really interesting. Thank you. Okay. Okay. Hello.
Hi.
Okay.
Me.
Yes, please.
My favorite book. I like the work of the Edgar Allan Poe.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
Murder of the Rue Morgue.
Mm-hmm.
It's suspense, drama, interesting and entertaining. It's like when you stay in, what will happen? Mm-hmm. The end of the story, oh, the killer was a gorilla.
Okay. Huh. Very nice. And man, talking about Edgar Allan Poe, there is a movie, creo que hay una película que hace poco salió, bueno, hace un par de años. Ah, it's interesting. Es bien interesante. It's about, no sé si la vieron, but I don't remember the name. No sé si se llama Corazón del Ator, no recuerdo cómo se llama la película. But it is about a killer. And that person has read, ha leído, all the books of Edgar Allan Poe. So this killer is killing people by following the all the details of Edgar Allan Poe. O sea que pasa todas las cosas así como Edgar las ha escrito. I recommend you.
Tiene otro libro bastante interesante, es Metamorfosis. Sí, ese es el Metamorfosis, creo que es del...
No, creo que es el escarabajo, no sé qué, que es de un tesoro. It's a treasure.
El gato negro.
La máscara de la muerte roja, I think there is...
Hay otro también, sí.
Good ones, very interesting, yeah. Okay, thank you. Good. Do we have any others? Thank you, Hugo. Any other volunteers?
Hi, teacher.
Okay, my friend, go ahead.
I want to tell you about the Amazing Spider-Man 2.
Okay. Toby Maguire, Andrew Garfield, or
no, Andrew Garfield. Yeah. Yes. Yeah, the amazing saga.
Uh-huh.
Okay. This movie is about a superhero. In it, the protagonist fight against powerful enemies. In the final scene, the girl he loves is killed in a fight against an enemy who was previously his best friend.
Mm-hmm.
He is known as your friendly neighbor, and the actors are Andrew Garfield and Emma Stone.
Okay. Let me tell you, that is the best Spider-Man in my point of view. And
yeah
he has too. Very amazing scenes. Tiene escenas bien interesantes, bien impresionantes. Yeah. Action, wow. I think it is good.
The scene in the die of Gwen is so good.
Yes, it's, and I like the other scene when people are on the stairs. Están en unas gradas. And Electro, yeah, like reacts with a lot of lightning, reacciones con electricidad.
Oh yeah.
And some people, yeah, are going to touch the iron tube, el tubo. And he, like, well, it is amazing the way he saves people, así como salva a la gente. So,
good one. Yeah.
Thank you. Okay. Let's see another. 1, 2, 3, 3 more. 3 más. Mm-hmm. Maybe. No, gracias, Silvana. Te queremos. Okay. Sí, teacher, pero no me pregunte. Okay. Carlos, what about you?
Okay. It is one to my favorite movie. It's a rape and revenge, an action movie.
Mm-hmm.
It's about two thieves, ladrones.
Thieves.
Thieves. Okay. Mm-hmm. It is about two thieves break into the home engineer Clay Shelton.
Mm-hmm.
The main actor is Gerald Butler. The name movie is Love, a Bowering Citizen.
It is with Jamie Foxx, right? Jamie, mm-hmm, Foxx is the lawyer, es el abogado, el fiscal.
Uh-huh. Correct. Yes. Yeah.
I really like that movie.
Yeah, yeah.
It's very sad what happens to Gerald Butler's family.
Yeah. Right?
And then he has like a revenge, tiene como su venganza. One person by person. Yes. I recommend that movie. Thank you. So, thief es ladrón, pero thieves, ladrones. Ok. Siempre que tengamos una palabra con F y la queremos hacer plural, va a llevar V. Como esta. Wolf. Tenemos wolves. Ok. Es parte de son sustantivos regulares, irregulares, perdón. Ok, who else? Maybe Silvana. No, teacher.
Mm-hmm. Ok, teacher.
Hasta suspira esta mujer, qué bárbara.
I want to describe of my favorite book.
Mm-hmm.
Is Mr. Mercedes. It's by Stephen King.
Ah, interesting. Yeah.
It's the story of war between good and evil. It describes a man that all the male obsessive and instant killer.
Mm-hmm.
And mention the different situations the killer imagines to make other the suffer many people.
Wow. Is there a movie about that book or just the book?
Only the book.
Only the book, yeah. But Stephen King has a lot of interesting books, like suspense or
horror. Suspense. Mm-hmm. No.
No, suspense, yes. I think I have read only the half of one, solo he leído la mitad de uno. And it is very detailed, bien detallado. Yeah, very interesting. Yeah, a good writer, un excelente escritor. Okay, después seguimos con esto, solo comentarles lo siguiente. Las palabras I was written, no se dice written, written, como mountain, curtain. Bien curioso esto, ¿verdad? Entonces, si escriben, si ponen, busquen esas palabras en un diccionario, se van a dar cuenta que se dice written, mountain, curtain, ¿verdad? No se dice mountain, curtain, ¿ok? So, just part of this vocabulary, ¿ok? So, what time is it? We already know how to ask for the time. And here we have, this is something very important. When we have the clock, tenemos el reloj. Si son las 2 en punto siempre se va a decir o'clock, ¿ok? Si son las 2 y 5, vamos a decir, miren, desde acá, ¿verdad? Hasta el 30, minuto 30 o hasta el 6, vamos a decir pasadas, ¿ve? Son las 5 pasadas las 2. It's 5 past 2. Pero como lo dije anteriormente, también podemos decir it's 2 and 5 minutes. ¿Se entiende? Yeah, no problem. But there are other forms to say. And if you have a conversation and a person says it's 5 past 2, ustedes deben entender, you have to understand that that person is talking about las 2 y 5. Okay? So, 2 y 10, 2 and 10 minutes, pero vamos a decir the 10 past 2. Las 10 pasadas las 2, ¿verdad? Aunque nosotros decimos, sí, pasadas las 2. Quarter, ¿verdad? Los ingleses dicen quarter, ¿verdad? Pero es quarter, and no es cora, sino que es el cuarto de algo y no el cuarto de habitación, sino que la cuarta parte de 60 minutos son 15, la cuarta parte de un dólar son 25 centavos, ¿verdad? Entonces por eso es quarter. In this case, it's a quarter past two, ¿verdad? So es un cuarto pasada la dos. Y aquí igualmente, 2:20 is 20 past two. 2:25 it's 25 past two. 2:30, aquí podemos decir 2:30, ¿ok? No recuerdo quién de ustedes lo dijo, 2:30, it's okay. Pero podemos decir it's half, aquí no se dice half, se dice half. La L es silent letter. This is half past two. Y eso pueden ver half time en Champions League. This half time, que es el medio tiempo. So half es la mitad. Y luego, aquí eso es más fácil porque aquí se lee así, ¿ve? 25 a las 3. To significa a o para, ¿verdad? 25 para las 3. It's 25. 2:30, pero podemos decir las 2:35, 2:35. 2:40, 2:40, pero aquí dice it's 2:23. ¿Ve? Son 20 para las 3. Esta parte es bien fácil porque se parece como lo similar form as we say it in Spanish. 2:45, it's a quarter to 3. Un cuarto a las 3. This is very simple. 2:50, 2:50, or it's 10 to 3. ¿Verdad? Es 10 para las 3. And 2:55, it's 5:23. Okay? So here we have, remember, half, ¿verdad? Past 2. Quarter, okay? So we're going to study this later. Ya vamos a estudiar eso después porque vamos a hacer un pequeño ejercicio. We're going to have like a very short exercise about the time, acerca del tiempo. Así que remember. So remember that you can say the time like the easiest form, like 2 and 5 minutes, 2 and 10 minutes. Yes, of course you can say it, but these forms are more common in English, ¿verdad? En el inglés es más común decirlo de esta manera, ¿verdad? Porque si dicen las 2 y 5, sí se puede, pero se escucha muy españolizado, ¿verdad? Pero of course you can say. Por supuesto que le pueden decir. Bien, vamos a hacer scanning. Como les dije, ya vamos a otra vez a tratar este tema. For me, it is important to have a short preview, una vista previa de un tema para que después lo volvamos a ver, para que esté como medio fresco. A veces el cerebro se satura it is overloaded, the our brain, with too much information, con mucha información. And this topic also we're going to study tomorrow. So, scanning, cuando vamos a scanning, necesito que, I'm going to present some information, so I need you to take some seconds to look at some words. Quiero que vean las palabras que ustedes consideren más importantes. Leanlas, sí. Scanning, ¿ok? Y luego me dicen de qué palabras son como las más importantes las palabras, the words that you remember, or what is the text about, ¿ok? So here I have, go ahead. Okay, Jesse, how tricky, qué tramposa, Jesse. ¿Por qué? Okay, Jesse, the última to Harris. Okay, Jenny, para que no te la gane, tell me.
Development.
Development, okay, good. What about Silvana?
Workshop.
Workshop, good. Hugo. Then Carlos.
Process.
Nice. Carlos, then Jesse. Sí, Jesse, tu turno.
Meeting.
Meeting. Miriam. Yeah, meeting. Yeah. Jesse, then Mabel.
Research.
What?
¿Me escucho? No. Research. Or
research.
Research.
Sí. Pero me gusta que inventas. Yeah. Mabel, your turn, then Naum.
Marketing.
Marketing, good. Naum, then Jose.
Department.
Yes. Jose.
Workshop and second.
Second, okay. Elenita, your turn, and...
Manufacturing.
Sorry?
Manufacturing.
Ah, manufacturing. Yes, yes. Te escucho diferente la voz. Ok. Alejandra. Ok. Roxana. Como la canción de Toto. Ok.
Company.
Company. Nice. What about Alejandra? No. Flor. Hello there. No. Yes, Flor. Can you mention one?
Tomorrow.
Okay, nice, tomorrow. Bien, ahora I'm going to present again this information y quiero que vean la hora y la acción. So, what happened in a certain time? Okay, sí pueden anotarlo, ¿verdad? Así como Jesse, ¿verdad? Pero no quité la cámara, Jesse, no hay problema. Así que pay attention to the time, pongan atención a la hora y la acción, okay. Because we are talking about an agenda. Estamos hablando de una agenda of a person. Okay? Go ahead. Okay. Ready. The first one is Jenny. Yes, Jenny. ¿Por qué, teacher? ¿Por qué?
Seven and... Ah. Sorry. 15. At 15.
Two.
Past.
Ah,
Seven.
Okay.
Past. Sorry.
Yes.
Quarter. At seven. Quarter.
Yeah, nice.
Oh, or quarter.
No, así estaba bien.
quarter past seven
or 17 past seven. Yes. Okay.
Okay.
What is the activity? Then Elena.
Meeting.
Miriam.
Meeting. Meeting, I don't know more.
Meeting, a saber con quién. Meeting, a saber con quién. Okay, nice. Elena, then Jesse. No se me escapa eso.
8 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
Video call supervisor.
Okay, like, nice. Pero me estás mintiendo. It is not 8 o'clock. Como no, ya ves.
¿Por qué? Because?
Because it is 8:30.
Ah, 8:30. Oh. Half past 8.
Excelente. A ver cómo le sacó la verdad a las mujeres. Okay, go. Jesse, and then José.
¿Digo a la hora de lo que me acuerdo o sigo?
Mira, mujer, vos ya notaste. You took notes. Ya tomaste un montón de notas, ok.
Apenas le respondo.
No, dale. Ay, rebelde. Ok.
12 o'clock. Uh-huh. Workshop. Go. Así vea. Workshop. No me acuerdo. Lunch.
Ahí sí. Ok, lunch. Perfect, nice. José, then Carlos, let's see.
9 o'clock, workshop, the research and develop department.
Yes, yes, good. Sí, y viendo, sí, de lejos. Ok, Carlos, and then Hugo.
Ok, 5:55, mm-hmm. Then tomorrow.
Schedule.
Remember.
Yes, I know that word is a headache. Dolor de cabeza, esa palabra. Okay, Hugo, do you have the last one? Bueno, era la penúltima.
No remember other, teacher.
Okay, you don't remember other. Okay, let's see. Mabel, any idea?
La 12? Que falta.
No, not 12. No, okay, no problem. So here we have Mrs. Robles. Okay, Mabel, what is Mrs. in Spanish? What does it mean?
Es señora.
Yes, señora. Mm-hmm. No le quita años a su vida. Yes, so Miss Señorita, Mrs. Señora, Mrs. Robles, agenda. Agenda is similar to schedule. Y todos me pueden decir, teacher, ¿por qué no mejor dijimos agenda en vez de schedule? ¿Verdad? Pero no, I'm sorry. So, I need you to read one by one. And the first person is going to be Silvana. ¿Ok? Silvana, number one. Lean la hora así como ustedes consideren. No problem. And then after Silvana, we're having Roxana. ¿Ok, Silvana?
7:55.
Decilo, relax, relajada. Decímelo, como vos consideras. Como te diga tu corazón.
Sí. Si mi corazón no dice nada.
I'm sorry, pues lo siento. Ok. Te voy a dar tiempo. I'm going to give you time. Roxana, the number 2.
Seven.
And then Linda, number 3. Ok. Roxana, number 2.
Ok, sure. 8:30.
Mm-hmm.
Video call with the supervisor from West Company.
Yeah, good. Mabel, you're ready with number 3, right? Okay, Mabel.
9.
Nine.
Workshop. Yeah. Workshop to the research.
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 Research. Yeah, research.
Research. Ay, no me sale.
¿Cómo no te salió? Research.
Research. And development department to improve the measuring.
Manufacturing
process.
Okay, nice. Let's ask to... Okay, Silvana. Number one. And then we have with this one, Elena.
7:15,
yes.
Meeting with marketing department.
Yes, vaya, pare de sufrir, sencillo. Okay, Elena, and then we have Hugo, this.
11 o'clock,
workshops, lunch.
Yes. Vaya, sí se pronuncia la S. Good. Hugo. Okay. And after Hugo, Jenny, the last one.
quarter to two. Second part of the workshop.
Yeah, nice. Jenny, last one.
5 and 55.
Oh, también tomorrow. Podemos decir, Jenny. ¿De qué otra manera lo podemos decir?
5 to 5 to I don't remember.
Para el último número te falta.
5 to 6.
No problem, no, así es la vida.
Sorry. I'm practicing.
Eso se oyó tan del Cora, tan del fondo del Cora. Okay. Okay.
So tomorrow is scheduled to meet Lopez, new secretary, and leave.
Yeah, tomorrow's schedule. Mm-hmm. Okay. A question, Carlos, what is improved? Any idea what is improved? Carlos? No.
No.
Okay, let's ask to Naum. Improve, Naum.
Well, in my personal opinion, mm-hmm. when you don't have the principal idea, but you say something similar.
Not necessary. Me llega porque oh, soy creativo. You are very creative. Soy bastante creativo. Ajá. Ok.
Improvisar. Nice. Improvisar.
No, no. Improve. Bueno, es lo que hiciste, pero está bien. Improve is mejorar. Improvise okay. Es mejorar. Improvise. Pero improve, ese verbo, anótenlo. Improve. This is very important. And you're going to find it. Por ejemplo, si les preguntan algo. Si les preguntan if you are on an interview and the question is tell me your weaknesses, dime tus debilidades, you don't have to say certainly your weaknesses. You can say I do different things but I have to improve some areas. Yo hago tales cosas pero tengo que mejorar ciertas áreas, because if you say weakness it means that you have a problem and you are weak. Entonces si ustedes aceptan esas que son debilidades, están diciendo que ustedes son tienen esa, bueno, son débiles en ciertas áreas. Ustedes, you have to be with a positive attitude and say, well, I do different things, for example, da, 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 but I have to improve, or I can improve, o puedo mejorar. Mm-hmm. Porque son
teacher, yep. I'm sorry, but it's difficult to talk about the mistake that I have, you know.
Is it difficult to talk about?
About the mistake.
Ah, los errores, yeah.
Because imagine you are in the interview, is that the only one change that you have to get a job? You have to say liar and something like that.
Yes, yeah. Well, you have to say the things different, in a different form. That's the point. Because as I have told you, it is a matter of attitude. Es un tema más que todo de actitud y de cómo ustedes enfocan la pregunta y sus ideas. Eso es todo. ¿Ok? Tampoco les digo que mientan. ¿Ok?
Ok.
That's one of the points. ¿Ok? Miren, 25 minutos and we, read the information again to answer the question. No necesitamos leer. We don't need to read again because we have a very good memory. So, I'm going to select, well, three people. And one is going to be, me gusta que cuando voy a seleccionar me hace una carita de no, yo no fui. Como Pedro Fernández. Helenita, yes, Helenita. Yeah. Solo mide. Okay, and José. Elena, select one. And then José. And then Roxana.
Juan? Mm-hmm. What time is the video call with the Watts company?
Yo creo que fue la que tú me dijiste, la que habías elegido, era, ¿verdad? En la que me mentiste, mujer.
No, no, no. Ay, ¿cómo no?
¿Ya?
Yeah. Yes.
Ve, 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 ve. Mm-hmm. Okay. What time?
It's 8:30.
Muy bien. En este caso, solo vamos a decir eso. At, ¿verdad?
At.
At. ¿Y cómo dijiste?
At 8:30.
Yeah, perfect. Okay. Good. José, right? A José le había dicho, ¿verdad? O a Hugo. ¿A quién le había dicho? Yes.
Yeah. Okay. Number two, what time does the workshop with the research department start?
Yeah, what time?
At 9:00.
At nine, yes, at 9:00, en punto, yeah. Como la clase de nosotros.
Yeah.
Y la última, si no me equivoco, fue Roxana, right? ¿Verdad, Roxy? Hello there.
Yes.
Number three.
What time does the company close?
Yeah, what time?
Five.
Mm-hmm. At five.
Sorry.
Uh-huh. I don't remember. At five to six.
Yep.
Six.
Yeah, 5 to 6.
After to see.
Yeah, excellent, nice. Okay, no problem. Can you see? Bien, ahora vamos con arithmetics. Vamos con la aritmética. Easy, cheesy. Como yo, I know that you are very intelligent and you should be working at NASA. Ustedes deben estar trabajando en NASA. We're going to have these procedures, estos procedimientos. Más se dice plus. Como... Así se dice. Más se dice. No se dice plus. Se dice plus. Plus, plus, plus. Y para decir igual, se dice equals. Plus, equals. Así que vamos a hacer estas cantidades. Esto va a ser voluntario. Algunos. Por ejemplo, 20 plus 30 equals 50. ¿Ok? Vamos a ver si es cierto que pasaron las PAES con buena nota. Mm-hmm. So, 20 plus 30 equals 50. Mm-hmm.
Okay, teacher.
Okay, Hugo, Hugo goes first, and then we have Naum, right?
B.
Mm-hmm. B.
Letter B.
Go.
30 plus 50 equals 80.
Equals 80, yes. Good. 80. Easy, easy, ¿verdad? Fácil. Si ustedes son calculadoras, andantes. Ok, who else? Naum, right?
Yes, just to share.
Ok, what letter?
F.
F. Mm-hmm.
Yep. 40 plus 60 equals 100.
Equals, ajá, con la S al final. Equals.
Equals 100.
100, 100 años de soledad, yes. Correct. Any other?
Hi, teacher.
Okay, Elena. Elena de José.
Letter E.
Letter D.
E.
E, okay.
Okay. 10 plus 80 equals 90.
90, good. Y también tenemos Roxana. Okay, so here we have José and Roxana. Mm-hmm.
Sí.
Sí.
60 plus 10 equals 70.
No, easy cheesy. Roxana, can you say letter D, please?
D, 20 plus 40 equals 60.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Perfect. That's nice. I was working in a private school like 7 years ago, and I taught mathematics in English. Yeah, it is it was very difficult. Fue un poco difícil, matemáticas en inglés. But can you see, we can do all these things and it is not a big deal, okay? Okay, books and movies, and we're going to finish with this in a short conversation, 19 minutos. Mm-hmm. El tiempo ha volado ahora. Okay, with movies and books, we're going to listen. Roxana, are you ready with your description? Roxana.
Okay. My description is about movie.
Mm-hmm.
Abominable is a movie about Everest. He's a strange creature, a yeti. Do you know how is a yeti?
Yeti, yeah, I think a yeti appears in Star Wars.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay. Three friends embark on a quest to reunite the creature with his family.
Mm-hmm.
They must keep him safe from a wealthy man in a zoologist who want to capture him.
Hmm. Okay. And at the end, they die or they survive or what?
In the end, he meets with his family.
Ah, okay.
Well, yes.
I don't know that movie. It sounds like very strange, but now I have another idea. I can.
It's very beautiful. Okay. Es en caricatura. Animada.
Ah, yes, I know it. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Muy bueno.
Yes, people say that it is a good message of that movie. Dice que tiene un buen mensaje la película. I haven't seen it. No la he visto.
Yes.
Okay. So, thank you. What about Jenny?
Okay. Hugo, one of my favorite books is Extraordinary Stories too, but my favorite movie is called Our Lovers. It is a Spanish movie and belongs to the romantic comedy genre.
Mm-hmm.
It is also related to literature. And it's about a girl who proposed a game to a gentleman about gentleman. Meeting about mm-hmm. not falling in love.
Mm. I don't know that movie, but it sounds like, is it old, vieja? No.
Relative.
Like 80s, 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 90s.
Relative. Old.
Okay, but it is Spanish movie.
Yes.
Okay, interesting. And there are different Spanish movies that are good. Mm-hmm. So okay, are you going to continue, Jenny? Oh, that's no. It.
Holy. No.
Okay, thank you very much. Okay, cold. Mm-hmm. Gender good. She said. Jenny said genre, very good. Genre significa género. It is especially for our artistic topics, for music, for movies, for books. But gender is female and male, ¿verdad? Eso es para el género masculino, femenino. Pero genre significa género musical, artístico. de libros, de obras, ok. So, literatura, todo eso. Ok, nice. What about Elena? Are you ready?
Yes, teacher.
Please.
It's a movie. It is a suspense and action film. It is about a man who kidnapped his daughter. His man begins. Comenzar.
Begin.
Thank you. Begin to look for contacts and people to help him look for this daughter. The kidnappers are not doing well at all sides. The work of the was a body work. The movie name is Taken in English.
Mm-hmm.
Spanish, Búsqueda Implacable.
Okay, yeah, Búsqueda Implacable with Liam Neeson, right?
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Very interesting movie.
Buena yeah. película.
Yes, yes, sí. Fíjate que la has mencionado como unas tres o cuatro veces, Elena. Fíjate, pero...
No.
¿O no es esa la que habías mencionado?
He mencionado, no, la de Orgullo y Prejuicio mencionado.
Ah, yeah. Ajá, but that is
a movie romantic. Love.
Mm-hmm. Es romántico, okay. Nice. Okay, thank you, Elena. Good. Habló ella de kidnap. Kidnap es este secuestrar. Kidnappers, secuestradores, okay? Yeah. Thank you. Silvana. Are you ready?
Teacher, ya pasé.
Ah, es cierto, y no te anoté, mira, ya pasé. Okay. ¿Cómo que es expo? Juez, Jesse, también, mira, ya es la edad, ya me está venciendo la edad. Jesse.
Sí, ya pasé. Mentira. Bro.
Ah, ya ven cómo, qué tan inocentes somos los hombres, ya ven. Fácil, caemos. Qué buena mentira de las mujeres.
Uh-huh. Yeah.
A ver.
Uh-huh. My description, a movie.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. It is a film that deals with sexual abuse.
Uh-huh. Abuse.
Against a girl, and then she takes revenge.
Mm-hmm.
And murders altos who abused her.
Mm. What's the name of that movie?
Beautiful Revenge.
Wow. I think she had like a traumatic situations because she was abused and it is not so easy to overcome. No es tan fácil superar eso. Yeah. Uh-huh. Well, it sounds, I think it is an action movie, a drama movie, right? Who are the actors? ¿Quiénes son los actores?
Ella es Carey Mulligan.
I don't remember. No recuerdo. Quizás la he visto. Maybe I have seen her, but I don't remember. Okay. Thank you, Jesse. Very interesting movie. Mencionó también la palabra against. Against significa en contra o contra de o en contra. Hello, Sam. How are you doing, my friend? At home, right?
Hello, teacher. Good evening.
Good evening.
Yes.
Okay, finally at home. So, do you have the description of a movie or a book?
I describe a movie.
Okay, let's describe a movie.
The movie is about two kids. And is the Second World War.
Mm-hmm.
And a Kid is Germany and other is Judy.
Jew. Mm-hmm.
Judy. Mm-hmm. And pijama.
Yeah, pajamas.
The pajamas.
Pajamas, yes.
Yes. Only.
Okay, I think it is El Niño en Pijama Rayas, right?
Right.
Yeah, it is about yes, a German boy and a Jewish, mm-hmm, a Jewish kid. Small. Yeah, it is a drama.
The name, mm-hmm, the name her is Shmuel.
Yeah, yes, I think it is. And the end of that movie is really hard. Es bien duro. El
sí.
Final. Yeah.
Pero okay. Me gusta porque, o sea, en realidad los seres humanos no somos malos, sino que la misma como
The society, sociedad, the environment, yeah, changes the people. Eso es lo que cambia a la gente. Okay, thank you. Very good. And let's listen now to Alejandra or Flor. Tal vez se puede escuchar porque we are about 8 minutes and we finish. So Alejandra, you there? Okay, maybe not. Flor, can you say hello?
Hi.
Okay, you have your description. ¿Tienes tu descripción, Flor?
Yes.
Vamos.
Description the movie. Mm-hmm. Film in the interior of happy.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Of happiness, where it took life is hard, and that you never have to give it up always. He's going to dispute everything.
Okay. What is the name of that movie? ¿Cuál es el nombre de esa película?
En busca de la felicidad.
Pursuit of happiness. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Pursuit of happiness. En busca de la felicidad. Okay. And 7 minutes y solo vamos a practicar una. Bueno, creo que serán dos conversaciones. And that's all. So here we have to finish. Conversation one. What time is the meeting? It starts, por favor, la S, ¿verdad? Starts, ¿verdad, Jesse? Starts. Y la S al inicio. It starts at 6:00. When is it over? It is over at 7:30. O pueden decir at 7:30, como ustedes quieran. Ya mañana sí les voy a pedir que digan de la otra manera. But today, relax. Wow, so long. Well, it might finish by 7:15 or it might finish by 7:15, ¿verdad? Might significa podría. Dice, wow, so long, wow, tan extenso, tan largo, ¿verdad? Eso. And number two. When is your first class? ¿Cuándo es tu primera clase? It is at 8:30 or puede decir at 8:30. Me too. When is your last class? My last class is at 3:45. When does it finish? At 5:15. Wow, so late. I know, ¿verdad? Long, might, by, late. Okay? Please, I need you to have a screenshot. Necesito que tome una captura de pantalla. Y lo vamos a practicar en literalmente 3 minutes. 3 or 4 minutes. No more. And I think we're going to do it only once. Solo una vez lo vamos a hacer. Yes, hasta con el flash. Okay. Nice. Okay, let's do it. Creo que solo vamos a hacer la number one, solo el número uno. Okay. See you in 3 minutes. Nos vemos en 3 minutos. Hello, Silvana. Vas conmigo. No te lamentes, mujer.
Ay, Dios, qué pena.
Porque, tranqui. Bien, 3 minutos y terminamos. Okay, vamos, comienzo. What time is the meeting?
It starts at 6 o'clock.
When is it over?
It's over at the 7:30.
Wow, so long.
Well, it's my and finished by 7:15.
Okay, when is your first class?
It is a 8:30.
Me too. When is your last class?
My last class is 3:45.
When does it finish?
At 5:15.
Yes. Wow, so late.
I know.
Bien, cambiamos ahora. Tú comienzas. Solo esta palabra la tienes que practicar, ¿ok, Silvana? Tu pronunciación es muy, fíjate que tu pronunciación es muy buena, pero hay palabritas que hay que reforzar, ¿ok? Vamos, tú comienzas.
What time is the meeting?
It starts at 6 o'clock.
Where is the over?
When is it over?
When is it over?
Is it over at 7:30?
Wow, so long.
Well, it might finish by 7:15.
When is your first class?
It is at 8:30.
Me too. When is your last class?
My last class is at 3:45.
When does it finish?
At 5:15.
Wow, so late.
I know. Muy bien. It's late, ¿verdad? Hay unas palabras que hay que practicar. Las últimas letras. ¿Ok, Silvi?
Ok.
Ok, te veo en clase. Ok, I'm going to check the... Hello, I'm going to check the attendance list. Vamos a revisar la lista de asistencia, la final. And we say, y decimos adiós, como decía Barney. Okay. So, Alejandra. Hello, can you say hello, Alejandra?
Present.
Okay, nice. And for the rest, I'm checking the attendance list. Okay, Carlos is not here, but Elena, no. Ernesto, no. Ever, no. Flor, hello, Flor, can you say hello? Flor, okay. I know that you are. Ah, thank you. Hugo, not yet. Jairo, no. Jenny, I'm checking the attendance list.
Hi.
Thank you. I'm sorry, guys. I'm checking the attendance list. Jesse?
Hi.
Thank you. Jose Palacios?
Houston, we have a problem.
Yeah, we have a problem. Linda, Vanessa. Linda. Okay. Mabel.
Present.
Hello. Okay, thank you. Mauricio, no. Naum.
Hello, teacher.
Thank you.
Hello, teacher.
Thank you. Reina, no. Roxana.
Hello.
Thank you. Vanessa, no. Sam, hello.
Hi, teacher.
Hi, Sylvie. Hello, Sylvie.
Yeah.
Carlos. Hello, Carlos.
Hello.
Elenita, que se me hizo.
Hi. Hi, teacher.
Okay, good. Hey, Hugo. Hello, Hugo.
Present.
Okay, creo que ya todos los mencioné. Así que, okay, my friends, gracias por su participación. No sé si alguien se me quedó. No sé si Mabel se me quedó con lo de las descripciones. Sí, ¿verdad, Mabel?
Sí, me faltó.
Mañana la decimos, ¿ok? Me recuerdas.
Okay.
Tomorrow okay. Me dice la descripción, ¿ok? Goodbye. Vayan a arroparse, vayan a dormirse.
Goodbye.
Bye, teacher.
Bye.
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 Mabel, creo que tú te toca ahora. A ti te toca ahora, Mabel. Let me check. Déjame revisar. 9:27. Yes, Mabel. It's your turn. Ahora te toca la sesión.
Teacher, voy a un parcial ahorita.
Ok, no problem.
Mucho.
No problem. Vamos a ver si después la reponemos o algo, ¿ok?
Ok, ok.
Ánimo, gracias. Suerte. Goodbye.
Gracias. Goodbye. Gracias.
Hello, Alejandra, can you hear me? ¿Me escuchas? Wow. Me parece que hay una dificultad. Okay. Today, the topic was how to use questions with time. It is a very important topic because it is not only just for asking the time, but also for expressing different situations or agenda meetings or different obligations or functions that an employee must do. We also study the ways to say yo también. So in this case, me too. It is easy to answer with these phrases. So in the case you say I am happy, you can answer me too or I am happy too. In the case, I love you, me too, I love you too, okay? And then here we have, so am I or so do I. So in this case, we say, I am happy, so am I. Or I love you, so do I. We also review the information questions, the words that are used for asking open questions, as it is seen here, how, what, when, where, who, why. Even we did a review of how to use different verbs like play, like, brush, work, take, by using the auxiliary does and do. For instance, here we have, what does he play football? I'm sorry, what does... Or we can say, what does Paul like the bus? Or where does she take the bus? And also, different types of information questions that we have studied previously. For example, where do you have lunch on weekdays? Where do you live? How do you get to your job? When is your birthday? What day is today? What do you want to eat? How often do you go to the beach? How often do you exercise? Even we may say, what's your phone number? What's your wife's or husband's name? What's your pet's name? Why do you study English? We did a review of numbers because to study the time, it is pretty important to know numbers. If a student has doubts or a student is not sure about how to express the time by saying the numbers, so in here you have a problem. So we studied numbers from 0 to 100, even the numbers that are used are from 1 to 60. And how to use questions with what time. For example, here we have what time and the answer. What time is it? It's 1:80. What time does the meeting start? It starts at 11 o'clock. What time do you arrive at work? At about 6:48 a.m. What time do employees leave? Usually around 7 or 7:30. We also have this exercise and with this instructions. Complete the questions using what time do or does practice the conversation with classmates. There is a recruitment of new employees on Tuesday. Really? What time does it start? It starts at 9 a.m. 2. Let's meet for the meeting on Wednesday. Great. What time do you arrive? I arrive at 8:15 a.m. 3. Tomorrow I have to go to the photocopy center. Me too. What time does the photocopy center open? It opens at 6:50 a.m. Wendy, do you want to have dinner with me after the workshop? Yes, but what time do restaurants close here? Around 7:25 p.m. 5. Amanda has to take some reports to my department on Monday. And what time do they open? They open around 7:30 or 8:05. We studied as well different forms to express this question. What time is it? So the examples are, what time is it? What is the time? Do you have the time? Excuse me, do you know what time is it? Could you tell me the time, please? And we studied the different forms to express the time, not only by using 2 and 5 minutes, but also it's 5 past 2. Or it is easy to say it is 2:10, but it is better to express it like it's 10 past 2. It's 2:15, or it's 1:15. It's 2:20, or it's 20 past 2. So in that way, the students learned to say it's 20 past 2, it's 25 past 2, or not only to say it's 2:30, but also it's 2:30, it's 2:35, or it's 2:25 to 3. Also 2:40, or it's 2:20 to 3. 2:45, it's 2:45. 2:50, it's 10 to 3. And 2:55, it's 5 to 3. Finally, we started Mrs. Robles' agenda. 7:15, meeting with the marketing department. 8:30, video call with the supervisor from West Company. 9 o'clock, workshop to the research and development department to improve manufacturing process. 12 o'clock, workshop's lunch. 1:45, second part of the workshop. 5 to 6, send tomorrow schedule to Mr. Lopez, the new secretary, and leave. As we have studied the different forms to express the time, now students can mention different times, different obligations or things that they have to do during the day at work. So this was the class of today. See you in the next class.